Oh, why is my hair always a mess when I do these videos? All right, today we're in Bilbao. Well, I'm in Bilbao. I signed up for a white collar a while ago. I'm talking January. To be honest, I thought I wasn't going to be able to do it in the end because I thought I might have been away, but I'm not away. The white collar's in July, the end of July. I'm probably going to be in Manchester for it. And I have a meeting in a minute where it's like a stream. And they're going to tell us exactly what it's about, what we're going to be doing. I feel like I'm a bit overqualified for a white collar skill wise, but I'm underqualified experience wise. Basically, I'm not going to go in. A lot of people have been telling me to go in and like, you know, don't make it obvious that, you know, you're skilled or you've been doing stuff for a while. Play dumb, go along with it and then win your fight. But I don't actually want to do that. I want to test myself. I want them to throw me in with whoever they think's right and I'm going to be at the other side. Whatever happens, happens. Obviously, I want to win. I'm pretty confident. I don't know the opponent yet, so actually I can't be confident whether I'll win or not. I'm not one of them people that go, I will win at all costs. If the odds are on me, I'll say it. But coming up to it, if I don't think the odds are on me, I'm just going to tell you now, I'll just do anything and everything in my power to try and win this fight. But to me, just turning up is a tick off the bucket list in my life. This is something I've been wanting to do, but I've been putting off for a long, long time. I mean, the pandemic got in the way. I probably started boxing properly at the start of the pandemic when I met Phil. Nah, this is the right time. This is the right time. It's perfect. This is what it is. Don't feel like I've got much to lose right now. Let's fucking go get it. Wait. Let me pull it back for you. Alright, this is Phil. Phil's my boxing coach. You want to know how I met Phil?
China has identified the cause of the
mysterious new virus.
Coronavirus.
Coronavirus.
So the pandemic was a hard time for all of us. I lost my job to an extent. I mean, I got it back as soon as the lockdowns ended, but I lost my job at the time. One of the things I really struggled with was the fact that all the MMA gyms was closed. I tried asking people all around me if they wanted to box, spar, hit mitts, and nobody would take me up on the offer. Until I remembered a number that I'd taken down a few months previous at a jiu-jitsu class before the pandemic had started. This number was Phil's number. I'd probably had it in the back of my phone for about 7 months. And as the restrictions were easing, but the gyms weren't open yet, I dropped Phil a text, not knowing what he would say, and he said, come down. When I first got there, I only thought that he was going to be interested in jiu-jitsu. But then I seen all the boxing bags around and I asked him. I said, do you do boxing? He told me he was a professional boxer and he'd been around the game 40 years. Now this was like a dream come true for me because I had wanted to get better at my hands for a long time. I had a Thai fight about 2 weeks in, but since then I'd not really practiced my striking too much. I was focused on wrestling and jiu-jitsu. But when I met Phil, I realised this was the time to learn how to box. Since then I've been boxing around 2 years with Phil. We had a couple others join us as well. We had Dan and Ant, who were both my size but very strong, stocky, and I'm convinced they were put on God's green earth to take my head off. So I've been sat here outside for about fucking 23 minutes, yeah. They said it starts at 7:30. I'm sat here and I'm like, it's fucking gone 7:30, man. Why has it not started yet? And he's taking a piss. And I realise I'm in Spain. We're an hour ahead. They're talking about how you'll feel after the 8 weeks of training. I mean, I've been training 2 years boxing. I'm more than qualified in the fitness area. But like I said, mentally, some of these kids could be a lot tougher than me. Mentally, they could be like, right, I'm just going to go in. They could just be game as fuck. I've had a lot of good rounds in my life, but I've had a lot of bad ones. I've had a lot of rounds where I've become a boxing bag. So every week they wanted us to weigh in, jump on a scale. This was probably more useful for people that were losing weight. I don't typically lose weight when I do training, but a lot of these people were going to lose weight. There was also every week MMA fighters in the cage. As our training was going on, they were training as well. As I was probably the most experienced person there, this training was quite familiar to me. But I did enjoy helping give the other people pointers. I hope my advice was useful. Just come out of the session. I spoke to one of the coaches who's called Adam, but I mentioned to him that I've been doing this a while and I want the gamest fight, and he said, of course, we pride ourselves on giving you the toughest fight we can give you. So I'm glad that we're all on the same page with that, because I don't want to go in thinking I'm fucking... I want a test, I don't want to go against somebody who's inexperienced, like, ruin their confidence. I don't want to be the guy who's, like, on the nights, like, fucking been doing... I've seen a guy who'd been training, like, fucking the 8 weeks, and the other guy I was watching, and I'm going, he has been training longer than 8 weeks. The other guy was just, his arms were upright every time the punches were coming. He was rolling perfectly. And I went up to him afterwards. I went, how long you been boxing, mate? He went, 5 years. And I was thinking, to be honest, the other guy gave it the rumble. He was fucking swinging for the fences. And I'm sure one of these guys, whoever they put me up against, is going to have so much adrenaline on the night that it actually might give them an advantage. I might just be too comfortable because I've done it too much and I get complacent, and anybody's got a puncher's chance, and one of these guys could just come in swinging at me, because I've got to keep that in my brain. I've got to keep that in my mind. Anybody's got a puncher's chance. Keep your fucking hands up. Treat it like you're fighting a world champion. I need to treat whoever this is, I don't care if he's been training 8 weeks, like he's a fucking world champion. So I've just pulled up at in Mossad. Man's gonna go check out Champs Camp, yeah? Because I only have a spar with Phil. Phil's fucking like 6'1", I'm 5'7", and he weighs 5 stone more than me. I'm not used to like someone being fast, so I need to kind of spar with someone my size. I know a few people from here. I know Culps comes in here, I see him on his Instagram sometimes. I know Mario Culpepper. And I'm gonna go check it out. Hopefully all these friendly faces are in there. Okay, so let me give you the backstory on Champs Camp. The gym was formed by Phil Martin, who was a professional boxer, also a left-wing political activist during the 1970s. He retired in 1978, but carried on his passion as a boxing trainer. He opened up the Champs Camp in a building that was left derelict after the riots of 1981. He went on to coach numerous talents from the area, some of them becoming British champions. He died unexpectedly in 1994 of cancer, age 44. But his name lives on, respected and remembered through Mossad.
Nah.
When you're ready,
man.
Yeah, man.
Start slow.
So the guy who invited me to Champs Camp, his dad was ex-world kickboxing champion Lance Lewis. I was very, very blessed for the opportunity of Lance to want to hold pads for me and teach me a bit about footwork. Mario is a very comical character. And while Lance was teaching me footwork, Mario kept cracking out the jokes.
Morris, don't mind you kicking the bag, as long as you ain't got athlete's foot.
But the best was yet to come. I got to spar somebody that I've looked up to for a long time. Fellow rapper, Robber Hollow.
Who's hot in your shirt? Straight from the top, light work.
Juice. Look. This has its own magic.
Moss side, stand up, this is manny shit. I'm in Moss way, puffing on a Cali split. Said he's the hood's hottest, that's a bag of shit. If I see a man in the hood, I would've bribed him. Told him, step outside, he weren't having it. All on the phone to his boss, he was panicking. Now he talk tough on the net, it's embarrassing. Talking tough for the gram, straight capping it. Anyway, back to the biz, I need prof. MGMCG, I need Dosh. That's my dad's name, must've got it from my pops. Why you think I'm out with these rocks? All I do shot, and all I know is guap.
Alright, so I'm editing this year and I just gotta say as a disclaimer right now, yeah. Robert Hollow, Defo, took this very easy on me. And I've picked all the clips, yeah, that make me look quite good. Because it's my fucking documentary. But I'm gonna show you at the end two jabs that he hit me with that absolutely fucking sent my head gut flying. And they made me realise that I need to work on my jab. Oh yeah, thank you, Robert Hollow.
Against anyone but tonight, you could go in exactly what you're saying. You've got one stiff ass guy, it's a 1 minute round and that, you're done. Yeah, or you can get someone that's exactly like you.
Yeah.
That's just doing the first fucking white collar, but they've got experience in that. This is why white collars are one of them.
I'm recording this, by the way. But I'm recording, right? So I'm watching him though, because I'm on my first day. I'm like, right, I've got to see who I'm fighting here. He's my size. He's my size. I'm going, ah, they're good.
You're not yourself. You can move shit on the pads, on the bags, and as soon as you get in there, and someone whack at you, bro. All of this shit goes out the window.
Mate, look at my hair. That's how you know when you've had a good session. Yeah, mate, I am well glad I went there. I fucking love that. I love training with Phil, but there's only so many times. You get used to each other. He knows all my tricks, I know all his. A couple of my tricks worked then. Not just that, but a load of other guys caught me with stuff that Phil wouldn't throw at me, or Phil would throw at me lighter because he's so heavy. That was fucking ill. And the fact that I got to train with Robert Hollow, I've loved Robert Hollow's music, yeah, since fucking... I probably heard Robert Hollow in 2012, 10 years ago. 10 years ago I first heard Robert Hollow's music, and now I've had a spar with him. I've had loads of moments like that. There's all these different people that you meet, that you look up to, that you see on like your fucking computer screen or your TV screen, and then you meet them, man, and you realise like you have the ability to do what people you look up to do. And it's fucking sick, man. I love it. Absolutely loved it today. So I wanted to explain something here, right? I was at camping with Ronan the other day, yeah? And we got talking to like why I started doing mixed martial arts, because I think people get the wrong opinion. I think some people might get the impression that I got into boxing and MMA because I love fighting. It's like, yeah, it's become that, but I come from a family where my sister was way older than me. I was in the house, I was pretty much an only child, yeah? And I had it quite, like my mum's very passive. My dad's quiet. My dad will defend himself if he needs, but he's a quiet guy. And starting around like year 5, 6, I just noticed that I got picked on. I was very small, and it continued to get worse, especially when I went to high school. I went to high school and I was probably the smallest person in my year, and even in year 8 I was smaller than all the new year 7s. Like, I was a small child. And at this time, just people were picking on me, man. People were just picking on me over and over again. I remember this one time in year 8, yeah, where there was this one time in year 8, right, where the cock of the year pulled me. I was walking down the corridor and he had like these stairs at the back to go to the higher corridor or lower corridor. I've come onto the stairs, right, and the cock of the year, yeah, who I'm scared of at the time, is with two other kids, and he goes, "Come here." And as I go over, he like puts me in the headlock or something, drags me to the ground. He starts trying to unbuckle my pants. Now, obviously this was like 14 years ago. So my impression now when I think about it is he was trying to just embarrass me. He wanted to like take my pants off so I had to like walk around in my boxers. He didn't manage to get my pants off. I started crying. After this, I jumped straight out the fire door. I went down to the bushes in this little area. There was this little area, so I went out the fire door. There was this little area where all the kids who were truanting could like wag it and not go to school. I hid down there in some bushes and I cried. And I was scared, man. And things like that continued to happen until I got in with a load of naughty kids. I got in with a load of, when I got, I used to have proper long hair and used to love rock music. And after a year or two of getting bullied, I ended up with a skinhead, and I was a smoker and I hung out with all the rough kids. We formed like a little gang and I got into a lot of trouble on my estate. I was just a product of my environment. And even with this gang, I was still scared talking 16, 17. Every time we got into trouble and stuff, like, I won't beat up. I was terrified of fighting. People think that I love... If you actually think that some people are just born loving fighting, it's not the case. We all seek comfort. We all seek the easy route. But at some point, I had to face my fears and I thought, I've got to learn how to fight. And at 20 years old, I still had that feeling. At 20 years old, I still felt like there was times where people would look at me, because I'm still small, I'm 5'7", where people would look at me like, yeah, I'd have you. And they'll treat you differently. But as soon as I started doing MMA, within the first few months, it's like you have an aura about you. You have a different sense. And it didn't make me want to treat people differently. It was just like a breath of fresh air. I advise every single person with children to get their children into some kind of martial arts. Not just that, a martial art where they're going to fight, where they're going to be tested. Because it calluses your mind. It trains you to be ready for the real world. And that's something that I wasn't ready for when I first hit high school. And it's something that I want to teach these kids. If I achieve any amount of success where I don't have to work anymore, I would train kids how to fight for free. Just so they don't have to go through what I had to go through. But at the same time, I'm glad I went through what I went through. It's turned me into who I am.
Oh. Just done one lap of the field. And I'm dead. But I'm going to do some shorter sprints. It's 2 minute rounds. It's not a marathon, it's a sprint.
So I was expecting a hard session. We weren't long out from the fight and I knew that Phil was going to put the pressure on. But I wasn't prepared for maybe the worst spar of my life. It was about 34 degrees and Phil brought his A game.
That's good stuff, boys. Love that.
Wow.
Absolutely love that.
Stools out, stand up, look at the opponent, look at the referee, acknowledge, respect the referee. Step forward.
Fucking love it.
Running out of steam.
Tired?
That's okay.
Tired?
We'll love you for it. You'll be so pleased.
I feel like I've got to take a punch with you to land one.
Yeah. You need a bit
I'll
of
give
a...
with you. I can't. Yeah, I can do that with smaller people, but with you. Yeah. It's just I'm not hitting you.
Yeah, that's okay. That's okay. But you did good. But you've got to hide that tiredness. You've got to hide it. You've got to start getting sexy. You've got to start fucking about. Steal a rest, know what you're doing when you're doing it, and get back in. Well, this is good hard stuff because you've got an old fucking warrior leaning on you, twice as heavy. It's great. You can smash away.
At the end of the day, yeah, I'm going to be going with someone who's like 60 kg, 61 kg. What do you weigh, Phil?
90 odds.
This is what we're pulling and pushing, and I'm sure you fucking did it to me today. You fucking give me a push and pull today.
No, I had to because you were strong as fuck. He pulls me off my feet.
But I'm like.
Hello?
Hi there, have you got anybody available today to cut and roll my hair?
What time?
Any time that's available? Yeah, how much is it as well?
About £30.
£30? Alright, and what's the address? Gotta go all the way up to fucking Harper Heath to get my hair braided. I can't find anywhere else. Okay. I didn't know this would be such a problem. Come all the way up to fucking Harper Heath, yeah? Woman told me it'd be £30 on the phone. As I get there, she tries telling me it's gonna be £50. £50? Are you having a fucking laugh? £50? Got it done 25 last time. Can't be having that. Sitting about because of my hair texture. Crazy. So I went all the way up to fucking Moston, yeah? And the lady tried charging me 50. And then the phone up me mate Tony to see if she knows anyone. And she goes, I can do it. So I just got my do-rag, yeah? Now I'm gonna go get my hair done. Son. Oh, it went right up my nose. Oh. Ready. Looking like Tarzan. Yeah, that looks way better. Yeah. Nah, do you suit him, don't I?
Yeah, you do.
Yo, Tony's sorting me out big time, you know.
Yeah.
Ask me what we're going to do now.
What are we doing?
Well, it's called the weighing. But I've already weighed in about 20 times. So I don't think it is a weighing. But this is where I find out who I'm fighting. I'm a little nervous. But I'm ready. I'm ready for anything, son. I don't need no compass. I always know where I'm going in life. So, I don't need a compass. Don't you dare get me a compass for Christmas.
I love it. Check this, right?
You know what I was thinking? Yeah. Obviously, I like all these guys, so I won't do it. But you know, if I proper rated someone and I was going to have a weigh-in, you know, like a stare down the picture and all that.
Yeah.
Get proper shit breath. That'd be fucking mint. Get proper shit breath. Like eat something. What would you eat?
Shit.
Actual piece of shit. Rub it on your teeth and then go head to head and be like, yeah. I'm gonna kill you. And they'll be like that. They'll look like this. Shit bag. They'll be like that. They'll be like that. They'll look like they're a fucking shithead. I'm doing that. If I ever need to. If I ever fight someone I don't like, you'll see. I'll have shit breath. Ask me where we are.
Where are we?
We're at Bowler's Exhibition, yeah? And on Saturday, 2 days, 3 days, 2 days, 2 days from now, I'll be fighting in there. I'm about to find out who I'm fighting now.
Oh my God.
Let's go.
Oh my God. Oh my God. Oh my God, oh my God.
I am going to call you out with the name that you've been asked to be called into the ring with. Just let me know if I do get it wrong. I'm just going to look at Brian every time you lot aren't shutting up and he's going to scream at you, okay? Just try and listen to this one. So, the way this is going to work, if you are called up first, you're in the red corner. If you're called up second, you're in the blue corner. There are 100 of you to call up. We haven't got 3 hours. So, if you're called up, it's going to be a quick walk. You're then going to stand with this X between your feet. Right? It's going to be your photo. Jake is going to be in front of you taking your photo. You're going to do whatever it is you want to do. It's going to be your profile picture for the next 6 weeks, so do whatever you want to do. That's fine. You're then going to stand to the side.
Your opponent's going to get called up, then you're going to have a face-off photo taken.
I couldn't handle the suspense of waiting for my name. My mouth felt like the Sahara Desert.
Luis the Lion Garcia. Fighting out of the blue corner, El Stanley.
All right. Oh. Come on,
Bill. As I stood up for the weigh-in, I noticed that the crowd went quite quiet. I'm not going to lie, it wasn't who I was expecting to get. I thought they were going to put me against somebody heavier, to be honest, to make up for the difference
here
in experience.
He's messing about with it. Look, that's a proper artist.
Like I said from the start, I ain't going to get complacent. Everybody's got a puncher's chance.
But everyone has a puncher's chance, like you say, yeah? But I fully believe that your abilities are going to take over you. You're winning this fight.
Listen.
Durag.
God's granted me an easy path. It must be all the hard years with Anthony and Dan. And Phil, it must be all the hard years of being punched in the face.
Oh,
well, you've got an easy fight here.
Fuck the money.
But you know what? It's still a test. It's still a big test.
Yeah. Do you know what? Mad respect for everyone that's getting in the ring anyway.
Yeah,
Warriors,
of course,
Warriors,
respect,
aren't
yeah,
they?
Yeah, of course, but, mad respect.
Well, let me ask you, how are you feeling?
All right, to be fair, mate.
How are you feeling?
Feeling good.
Never had a medical in it. Can't see my opponent yet. Past the medical. I wanted to record it, but I just felt it was a bit awkward. But here we are. Backstage. Right, these are one of the two kids that I thought I was going to get. Tough motherfucker A, and then tough motherfucker A. I thought I was getting one of them two. And here's me dad.
I was only joking. That weren't me dad. That was Brian. And I want to thank Brian for 8 weeks of living hell. Nice one, Brian. I had to get you back.
10 pesos. Come on, go!
Brian was also going to corner me, which I was excited for because I got on with him well.
Look like a fucking naughty R&B rapper. Probably got about 2 hours. Sweet!
And Stanley!
And then we'll give a thumbs up, you'll hear the MC, he's going to introduce your fighters tonight. When the MC introduces the fighters for tonight, we will let you go, you'll start walking on just like we were. Red corner goes there.
While I was stretching, the fight order got put on the wall and everyone ran to it.
All turned into a pack of animals, man. There's my fucking name.
I want to know your predictions. Mystic Mac. Yeah. Is. Oh, he's quick. Oh. You got this, man. You got this confidence.
Right there.
While I was waiting for my fight, I got to watch a few of the others. It was great entertainment, not gonna lie. Figured out how I've ended up with the kid that I ended up with, right? He put down 5 months experience. I put down my honest, 2 years boxing experience. So essentially, they've looked at that, they've looked at the weight, and they've looked at the height, and that's how they've matched it up. On paper, we look quite similar, but I can't get complacent. I've got to have some humility. He could whack me. I have no idea, to be honest. I've only seen very little of him, but it is what it is. Wish me luck. Thank you for everyone who's come to see me. I'm thanking you in advance. This has been an experience, and I can't wait to walk out there and do this thing.
The ideal is you get to ringside red hot. Yeah? Red hot. Nothing's going to get pulled.
Boys, love that. Absolutely love that.
The feeling our skill levels were going to be unmatched, but when it came to heart, this kid brang it, and I'm not going to lie, he put me on the back foot many times. After the first round, I'm gonna tell you now, I was absolutely gassed. But not gassed enough to not look pretty while the cameraman took my picture.
Come on, Carl!
I'd used a lot of energy, I threw too many power punches, and I told myself that I was gonna be more cautious in the second round.
Come on.
It was about a minute into the third round and I could hear Phil screaming at me. He was screaming for me to go in for the kill, and that's exactly what I did. I had to give it to the lad that fought though. Lewis Carside put up a great fight considering he'd only been training for 5 months. And I don't think he should be ashamed one little bit with the decision. But tonight was my night. And to be honest, I left with the feeling that I should believe in myself more. I'd been training a long time, and even though I didn't know who I was going to get for the white collar, I think I underestimated my skill level. The next time I fight, it's either going to be an amateur or it's going to be in KOTR.